Good morning, everyone. I'm Becky, and I want to thank you all for being here to celebrate the class of 2020, despite all of the chaos in our world right now. This isn't really what we expected for graduation when we first walked through those mall hall doors 4 years ago, but I can think of no better venue than Burley to commemorate this class. We've celebrated countless wins on this field, and we're here celebrating another one right now, the successful end to years of school and all the smaller victories in between. Everything from the past 18 years of our lives has come to this moment, and we should all be incredibly proud of that. So congratulations to each of my classmates for making it here. Personally, I know I couldn't have done it without some motivation. I want to thank my family and friends for giving me all of the support I needed to achieve my goals and persist to stand where I am today. I'm confident that everyone here has also had a great support system behind them because I'm witness to our caring community and supportive school. Without the encouragement that the Greeneville City School System has given me since my first day of preschool, I'm not really sure who I'd be besides a lesser version of myself. These past 4 years alone, my high school teachers not only taught me the academia necessary to receive a diploma, but also the life skills necessary to succeed once I exit the stage. In science, I didn't just learn how many newtons you need to support a 200-kilogram box, but I also learned about supporting others. Greeneville High Science Department is unmatched in the support and care provided by teachers with traditionally challenging material. Every science teacher goes out of their way to ensure that their students grasp chemical formulas or kinematic equations without becoming discouraged. Without their support, I and others like me might have considered ourselves incapable of comprehension. The science department's encouragement helped us all feel confident in ourselves. I aim to exhibit the same tone of encouragement to help others succeed as I know they can, because just as this reassurance helped me, I know it will help others. This goes to show that we must support our peers and encourage their success because we rise by serving those around us. Not only should we be willing to help others, but we should also learn to accept their help. In English, I read and analyzed the works of Poe, Shakespeare, Fitzgerald, and many others, trying to figure out what each author meant in the specifics of their language. From this, I discovered the importance of listening to others to recognize the intention of their words. It's an essential skill to listen to and value other people's thoughts and stories. Listening to the advice and wisdom of others will guide and strengthen your own ideas and experiences. It's not easy to accept help when it's offered to you, especially at this age when we all want to be independent, but we have to recognize that those around us are willing and excited to help us achieve our goals. Rather than only depending on ourselves, we should learn that it is okay to accept the guidance of others. In math class, I learned fundamental ideas essential for my career, like solving for x or finding the antiderivative of a trig function. However, outside the confines of the syllabus, I also learned fundamental ideas essential for finding real-life solutions. My math teachers taught me not to overthink and to avoid stressing out over simple problems. Mrs. Gaby commonly told our pre-calculus class to follow the KISS method, which means to keep it simple, stupid. We can't allow elementary problems to trip us up when the solution is much simpler than we anticipate. Do not overcomplicate life. This doesn't mean to be lazy and take the easy way out. Rather, I'm saying to take it easy and don't overstress because life is short. If we spend all of our time worrying about what happens next, we will miss out on what's happening around us. We need to stay in the present and enjoy the now rather than be anxious about the future. While life shouldn't be overcomplicated, it's also important to allow life to not be perfect and learn from your mistakes. Growing up, social studies was never ranked among my favorite classes. Because of my aversion, I never studied, forgetting who Alexander Hamilton was and why the Geneva Conference is relevant, so history soon also became my worst class. However, after realizing our main motivation for studying history, which is to avoid repeating the past, I learned how to easily avoid failing my APUSH exam, actually start studying. It took me going halfway through my junior year to figure that one out, but this is for everyone else that hasn't learned it yet, study. Having a teacher like Mr. Morrell was also helpful. He knew how to make things interesting. But just as we have learned how damaging prohibition was to our economy, I've learned how damaging academic neglect is to my GPA. Pay attention to what happens in your past, and instead of regretting what you did wrong, just learn how to prevent it from repeating. Sometimes the answer is right in front of you, like pay attention in class or give the people their alcohol. Sometimes the answer is not as easy to find, like having an honest conversation and apologizing for something you did your sophomore year to let go of old grudges. Either way, looking into the past will help improve what happens to your future. And to my high school class, I consider you all some of my greatest teachers. From you, I learned to enjoy every moment and take every opportunity I'm offered. From our first failed math quizzes to our last Friday Night Lights, we've been through it all together, some of us even since our very first day of elementary school. I know we all had different expectations for the end of our senior year. However, this is just one hurdle in our path. As we continue through life, crossing each barrier one at a time, making mistakes and gaining new experiences, we must take advantage of every opportunity that comes our way to avoid regret. As Mrs. Hankins would advise, carpe diem. Yeah. Although our lives are much different than they were March 13th, the last time we were all together, and our final everythings came before we expected them to, we're not holding on to everything we missed out on. Instead, we're eager to see what comes next. I know everyone here is capable of doing whatever they set their mind to, and I'm excited to see where we all go from here. To the class of 2020 and everyone here with us, I'm grateful that you taught me more than just what's in our textbooks. Thank you.
No, sir, I want you to. All right. Good morning, good morning. How are y'all doing today? I want to give a big shout out to Becky because it takes a lot of gumption in order to hop up here and give their speech first. So I really want to thank my peers for selecting me to be one of the people to come up here and give this speech. So when I was thinking about what I was going to talk about, I was thinking, you know, graduation speeches. I decided I didn't really want to reminisce over the times we had or think about the times that we lost. More so, I'd like to give you guys a word today. Now, you can take this, use it as you want to use it, but this is a story that I heard at the beginning of this summer, and it's really changed my life. It's changed my outlook on things. I wake up every day with a purpose now. Now, this is a story. His name was Eric Thomas. He gave this talk. Now, Eric Thomas, he's a motivational speaker. He goes around the country giving talks and stuff. So I found this speech, and here's how the story goes. It's about a super rich business guru and just a young man like me who's wanting to be successful. So the story goes, the young man goes up to the guru, and he asks him, he says, "Sir, what did you do to become so successful?" And the guru looked at him, he said, "You want to be successful? I want you to show up to the beach at 4 a.m. Now, of course, the kid, he's thinking, you know, I want to be successful. I don't want to go take a swim. So he shows up at 4 a.m. The guru, he's already out in the ocean swimming a little bit, and he says, "You still want to be successful?" And of course, he's like, "Yes, sir. I mean, it's early, you know. Nobody wants to be up this early if they don't want to be successful." So he takes that. Now he says, "Come out into the water." The guru does. So the young man walks out there. He's at about his waist now. Oh, his suit's getting wet. And he says, "Now you're out here in the water. Do you still want to be successful?" He said, "Yes, sir. Of course." So he said, "Come out a little bit farther." So the young man continues to walk out to the guru. He gets higher and higher in the water. And now he's at about his neck level. And the guru says, "You still want to be successful?" And of course, I mean, he's going to say, yeah, he done came all this way out into the water. And before he could say, "Yeah, I want to be successful," the guru grabs him by his shoulders, puts him under the water. And now the dude's flailing, you know, he's going crazy. He can't breathe. So he's panicking. He's about to pass out. That moment before he passes out, though, the guru picks this young man up out of the water. And he asks him a question. He says, "When you were under that water, what did you want to do?" Now, that young man, he said, of course, he wanted to breathe. So what this means, what this has meant to me is the guru said after that, when you want to breathe as bad as you want to be successful, only then are you going to achieve that. So after I heard that, you know, I filled up the bathtub and jumped in. No, I'm just kidding. I didn't do that. But what I did start doing was thinking about high school, and I realized they instilled in us a want and a peak to look towards to be successful. But what I never really comprehended was the work it took or the drive or the passion. So this story was really that pivot point from knowing what you want to do and a call for action. So, you know, I looked back and I thought about people who wanted to do something as bad as they wanted to breathe. I think about Ty back here running through 15 people on this football field to score a touchdown because he wanted to get in that end zone and help his team out as bad as he wanted to breathe. I think about Becky. I'm sure most of y'all know she's going to be going to Princeton this fall. Now, a lot of y'all are probably aware of all the work she had to put in. She put in hours and hours of studying, hours of papers, hours of interviews she had to do. But she went through all that stuff because she wanted to do it as bad as she wanted to breathe. I even think about Carolyn. Carolyn spent hours and hours practicing her trombone so that she could be in the premier parade in the nation, Macy's Day Parade. She sent who knows how many videos of her working and stuff, but she did that because she wanted to succeed as bad as she wanted to breathe. So guys, we're graduating here in a special time. The coronavirus, everybody's counting us out. I mean, you know, this class, they didn't get the full education, so to speak. I challenge you all today to take this opportunity of people sleeping on us, so to speak, and really just find that passion. Chase and build that dream and create your idea of success. And when you come up with that idea, you come up with that dream, you come up with that goal, regardless if it's college or work, anything that you're doing, chase that dream, pursue that idea with the exact same intensity as you want to breathe, and I think all of us will be successful. Thank you, guys.
It's kind of hard to breathe in that thing. Well, greetings, and thank you for joining us on this really special day. Finally here, and it's a good thing. So, class of 2020, on this day, we can finally say that we are no longer in high school. Even though this is a commencement ceremony, right now it feels more like a ceremony of closure. So thank you to the people who worked hard to give the class of 2020 the closure we need. A special thanks actually to the maintenance and custodial staff, people over here, and everyone who did everything from setting up this stage to pressure washing the bleachers to putting the chairs out. We thank you for doing that for us. And Mr. Fraley, thank you for sticking with us for 4 years. Greeneville High will miss you. The circumstance for our gathering today, it makes for one very unique story. We as a graduating class and even world citizens will never forget this year and the events that are still shaping it. However, today, we come not to focus on any of those negative things, but on the great accomplishments of this class and the futures that lie in front of us. To start, as students, we remember the theme for our winter formal dance every year. Really fun time. Make a difference. But what does that mean? With this short time in our lives to make a difference, I want to ask the class of 2020 a simple question. Are you living for the point or for the line? Living for the point is caring for things that will only impact ourselves. The line represents a much bigger picture. Eternity past and eternity future. We are right here living in the middle. The question is, are we leaving this world better than we found it? We've all done things that will impact the future. However, we must do better. We must live for the line. And it starts with relationships. Every interaction that you have with another person is an opportunity to make a difference. Whether it be family, friends, coworkers, strangers, be kind because everyone is fighting a hard battle. All you have to do yourself is look. In our amazing GHS business department, I learned that the basis of for economics and personal finance. More importantly, I learned that the best investment is not always monetary. The greatest investment we can make is in the lives of others, because impressions and memories, those live on forever. Live for the line. When we live for the line, we keep perspective in mind. In my favorite book, To Kill a Mockingbird, the father Atticus tells Scout that you never really understand a person until you consider things from their point of view, until you climb around in their skin and walk around in it for a while. This is so true in my life. I've been guilty of placing a greater value of my own problems over the problems of others. Therefore, in our lives, we must consider what others go through and do as Matthew 7:12 calls us to do and treat others how we want to be treated. Live for the line because it's bigger than us. To my fellow classmates, as we enter this world, we're kind of already in it. I challenge you to do what Alexander Hamilton said and stand for something or you will fall for anything. Whether it's fighting for social justice, whether it's standing up for your religious beliefs, whether it's even voting in your first major election, make sure you do that. Make it your life's passion. Claim something and run with it. Never believe that you are incapable of achieving that thing, because when you do, you've already failed. The irony of having graduation here at Burley Stadium is undeniable for me. In fact, before I even set foot in a high school classroom, I started here as a football player. The lessons that I learned here helped me to realize how living my life for others, not myself, is what wins ball games. There's not enough time, but pick a spot or a chair on this football field, and I could tell you something that happened in that very spot that has helped me make me the person that I am today. Finally, as I bring this circumstantial graduation speech to a close, it's starting to feel more like final goodbye. And I closed this book, start a brand new one. During the last few months, I've been thinking a lot on where I've come from and where I want to go. I have very big goals. And without a family who supports me in everything and God who guides me along right paths, I would not know where to start. I'm especially grateful for my sister Ellie Beth and best friend, who I will miss the most. In the words of my favorite Avenger, Tony Stark, part of the journey is the end. However, the end of this chapter does not mean the end of the relationships which made high school so worth it. Class of 2020, don't be satisfied with where you are here and now. Don't let high school be your peak years. If I had one more day in Greeneville, I would want to spend it at a lunch table or walking the halls with each one of you, my friends. The life before all of us from this point is completely up to us. So don't be satisfied with living for this point. Live for the line. Thank you. Go Green Devils.
Okay. Good morning, graduates of 2020, and parents, family, faculty, and administration. It's really bright out here, and I'm a little nervous, and there's a lot of you, so just bear with me. We may be a few months late, but nonetheless, here we are. Graduation is no longer a distant reality. Our futures begin here, and they begin today. Over the past several months, I'm sure we've all been asked, are you glad to be done with high school? Because I know I have. It should be a yes or no answer, but is it really that simple? Because yes, I'm sure we're all glad to be done sitting in the same classrooms day in and day out. Yes, it will be nice not to have to do the same routine every day, going to the same classes and doing the same work. And yes, I'm sure none of us will miss walking through the crowded mall hall, having to touch every single person just to get to class. And yes, it will be nice to finally have the freedom to decide what we want to do with our lives. However, that doesn't mean we won't miss the good things. Easily becoming friends with people in the same classes as you. Watching or getting a singing Valentine from our talented chorus. Rooting on our athletic teams to multiple state championships. Listening to the continuous sound of the Kiker Cannon every Friday night. Participating in casual lunchroom conversations that can turn into anything and everything. Cooking with Mrs. Wells, where we learned much more about life than just making nutritious meals. Watching history come alive with Mr. Morrell as he flailed his arms in excitement. Learning not only French from Miss Ward, but also love encouragement, and friendship. Stressing through hours of green packets with Ms. Watts and Ms. Wright, only to later realize how valuable that would be on our ACT exams. Being greeted by the English teachers standing at their doors as we walked down the English hall. Being thankful for the semesters when you didn't have a science course so that you didn't have to take three flights of stairs to the science floor. But science teachers, that doesn't mean we loved you any less. Learning how to use VPNs so that we could freely use the school's Wi-Fi. Sorry, Mr. Robertson. Waiting at least 10 minutes to get out of the back parking lot in the afternoon to avoid the inevitable collisions. Feeling annoyed by the lower classmen sitting on the senior bench in the mall hall when we felt like we had patiently waited our turn. Changing our perspective of faculty and staff from intimidators to family members. And of course, the thing we took for granted at the time, but now we miss terribly, being with friends together in the same place at the same time. We had no idea that when we left for spring break on Friday, March 13th, that our 13-year journey together would come to an end. No more tennis, track, soccer, basketball, softball, baseball, no hugs, and no in-person goodbyes to teachers and friends that mean so much to us. We've been told our class was special since sixth grade when we got kicked out of the Atlanta Zoo, and we are special. Recently, a friend shared on Facebook a quote that went something like this. You were born when the world was grieving over 9/11, and you graduate as the world grieves over a pandemic. Although your two biggest launches into freedom, birth, and graduation, have taken place in the midst of tragedies, just know that the world is an amazing, beautiful place, and it's waiting for you with open arms. You were made for this. When I think of that quote, and I think of our class, my favorite Bible verse comes to mind. Perhaps you were made for such a time as this, Esther 4:14. We're a class of fighters who have endured and conquered many obstacles. Our class now understands how to be prepared for the unknown and the uncertainties of this world. We understand and recognize the value of persistence and not giving up hope when life feels hard. And most of all, we understand and appreciate how precious life really is and how we must embrace it and live in the present because we aren't promised tomorrow. Up until now, we have shared a similar journey. As we move forward, some of us will leave for college, some will join the workforce, some will take on the military, and some may still be deciding what's right for them. Wherever your future takes you, classmates, my hope for you all is that you achieve decades upon decades of success and happiness. May you find joy in all the little things. May you live for the moments that take your breath away. May you find ways every day to make the world a better place. May you be the person who cares, who makes people feel seen, who loves without fear, and who believes in the goodness of the world. May you value and love the people that helped you become who you are. May you view the world as something to be conquered. May you become whoever it is you want to be, you hope to be, and who I know you can be. Lastly, we should all thank those who have helped us achieve our goals. I know this day would not be complete without thanking Jesus, my family, and my closest friends for all the time, effort, and love they've poured into me. I would not be the person I am today without their unconditional love and support. So today, we say goodbye to everything comfortable and familiar about Greeneville and close this chapter of our lives. Today, we take a step into the unknown. We walk toward our futures, never forgetting the lessons learned, the memories made, the forever friendships, the love shared, and the people who shaped us. May we always pass under the ye old town gate with full and fond hearts. Regardless of when or where we gather next, it's been an honor to spend the last 4 years with you. So to answer the question, am I glad to be done with high school? Of course I am, but of course I'm not. As we say our goodbyes, I am reminded of Winnie the Pooh who once said, "How lucky am I to have something so special that makes saying goodbye so hard." Congratulations, classmates. Thank you.
Well, if nothing else, I found a new skill I can do. I'm a great podium wiper. Greetings, class of 2020. How could we have ever dreamed that we would end up here like this? I'll spend some time shortly listing the accolades you have learned along your path to today, but I'm first going to talk about some things that I would like to see continually guide you as you march victoriously into the paths that lie ahead. No, this morning is not the end of a journey, it's a beginning of a new path. We have only prepared you to leave and continue to learn. You've received an excellent start in Greeneville City Schools. Remember, this ceremony is called commencement. So commence. Commence to strive for more. Reach higher and farther. Continue to kindle the Greeneville spirit of great character, hard work, and success. We've talked about that for your 4 years here. Also know that the H doesn't only stand for hard work, but it also stands for heart. It's my most sincere wish that each of you leaves your days at Greeneville High School knowing that you leave us with a piece of our heart. We have been blessed to give those pieces to you. Now, as you have already shown us you are capable of, take these pieces we have given you and spread them into the world. Build your dreams by continuing to invest your heart into everything you do. If there's a score to be kept, win. If there's a way you can do good for others, serve. And if there's someone who is in need, give. It's been said that Admiral William McRaven gave one of the best commencement speeches of all time in 2004 at the University of Texas. If you've never seen it or heard it, you can Google "Make Your Bed" and you will find it there that you can watch. It's very powerful. There's one of the principles that he shares that reminds me of this class and the difficult circumstances that you have had to deal with this year. It is principle 4. Get over being a sugar cookie and keep moving forward. He tells the tale that in Navy SEAL training, there are inspection after inspection of the uniform, and the minimum acceptable level is perfection, which is, of course, unattainable. When you fail this inspection, you're ordered to run into the surf, fully clothed, return and roll in the sand while you and your clothes are sopping wet. They call this a sugar cookie. He goes on to speak much more eloquently than I, but his point is this. You're never going to be perfect. There are always going to be circumstances in your life where you will fail, come up short, or like this year, be dealt a bad hand. But the folks who survive Navy SEAL training are the ones who succeed in life, are the ones that accept this reality. Move on and do not dwell on how unfair or how cheated they may have been. Don't wallow in self-pity and don't think that the world is against your success. The ones who make it are able to shake it off, survive the day covered in wet clothes and covered in wet sand, and make the best of what they can do from that point on. This is what you, the class of 2020, will be remembered for. I said early on in the quarantine of the spring in one of my weekly messages that I sent out that this class will be remembered as the ones who persevered. And here you are. Take these lessons with you. If we know there are going to be problems, and there will be. Embrace it in all that you do, whether it be in additional schooling, work, marriage, parenting, just life in general. Give the best you have. Invest your heart in what you do always. Very few remarkable things have ever happened in this world without one person first having a dream and then deciding to somehow get over, around, or through the obstacles put in their way, put their heart into it, but mostly you got to get to work. Carry that spirit and drive forward in your lives. That's what it means when we say, class of 2020, the ones who persevered. Also, when we say, D for L, or devil for life. This class of 2020 is an exceptional group of young people who have proudly carried on the grand 127-year traditions of Greeneville High School. We began 4 years ago with a vision of preparing these students to be future ready. Some folks have asked, and we tried to relay, what is this future-ready business? But put quite simply, it's that our students would get to today and graduate having tools that would allow them to be successful in whatever their future plans may be, to own their future. You might ask, what does that look like? How is it measured? Some indicators that have developed are noted in your program with the small green print after the names are as follows. Does the graduate have an industry-recognized certification in hand when they graduate? Will all 79 members of the class who have an industry-recognized certification please stand to be recognized? You can kind of tell we didn't get to have graduation practice. So, guys, if you don't remember what you got, look in your program. It's a little green letters right after your name. Sorry about that. Does a graduate have post-secondary or has taken an AP course with the potential to gain college credit verified on their transcript before graduating from GHS? It means you took an AP course or you took a dual enrollment course while you're here. Will all 137 of you who did please stand to be recognized? Thank you. Does a graduate meet the college and career readiness benchmarks identified on the ACT test? That means you made a 21 or above a composite. Will all 116 of you who did please stand to be recognized? Has the graduate demonstrated that they have marketable skills that are valuable in the workforce? This means you've earned the work-ready diploma or the LEAP distinction. Will all 68 of you who have please stand to be recognized? We also have in this class a young lady who not only has had 13 years of perfect attendance, but she also earlier this spring graduated from Walter State with her associate's degree. Miss Chloe Waldrop, would you please stand to be recognized? These are five major measurable areas that show future readiness, but there are more intangible, less concrete examples as well. Do they have a sense of community pride? Are they empathetic to others? Do they take personal responsibility for their actions? Can they work well with others? Do they have the determination to keep grinding when the going gets tough? All these traits are the cornerstones of the entire Greeneville City Schools educational experience. And I can say with pride, this group of graduates has learned those lessons well. There have been times in our four years together that we've struggled and butted heads over some of these traits, like taking responsibility for your own actions. But I want to take the opportunity this morning to convey to you again just like a father looks lovingly at his children, he still has to correct them when they get out of line. He hurts when they hurt, but most of all, loves them through it all. And if you can't tell, I kind of got those fatherly feelings right now. Always know that P. Frey loves you. We began our journey together four short years ago, and I couldn't be any prouder of you right now. Through ups and downs, highs and lows, championships and quarantines, we can collectively now say we're all the better for it. I challenge you to never give up on what you're working on or toward. This morning, I share with you an illustrious example of graduates who own their future. As this group celebrates the closing of their 13 years of education in Greeneville City Schools, I look forward to the coming years, hearing and witnessing the great things you are doing. And remembering the special 4 years I've got to share with you. With your hard work and the support of this entire community, you have accomplished much. We all now collectively say, great work. Individually, the class of 2020 consists of 209 students receiving diplomas. Members of this class have been offered scholarships totaling just over an impressive $4 million. Add to this number 181 seniors eligible for Tennessee Promise and 129 Hope Scholarship recipients. Seniors, if you have earned any sort of college scholarship for your hard work and accomplishments while at GHS, please stand to be recognized. We are also extremely proud to recognize four of our graduates tonight who will be leaving, or today, who will be leaving or have already left us to serve in the National Military Service. Will you please stand and allow us to express our pride and appreciation to you? They're all gone. I think most of them had commitments that they had to be at boot camp over the summer. So. Class of 2008-20 boasts 81 GHS Honor Scholars, marked with the gold stole, 64 GHS Community Service Scholars, that's a purple cord, 67 State of Tennessee graduates with honors, those are blue cords, 76 State of Tennessee graduates with distinction, those are white cords, and 63 TriStar Scholars, and that's a medal that they're wearing. Director Starnes, with great humbleness and pride, I thank you for the opportunity to one last time, on behalf of the entire faculty of staff of Greeneville High School, to present you and the Board of Education, the members of the GHS 2020 senior class, for the awarding of their diplomas. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Fraley, for that heartfelt message. Good morning, and welcome students, honored guests, faculty, staff, administrators, and those watching the live stream to the commencement ceremony for Greeneville High School Class of 2020. We're glad that you have chosen to share in this joyous occasion. Before I begin, I would like to take a minute to recognize the Greeneville City Board of Education. First, our board chair, Ms. Cindy Luttrell. Our vice chair, Dr. Craig Shepherd. Our treasurer, Mr. Jerry Anderson, Mrs. Pam Botta, Mr. Josh Quillen, and Mr. Adam Heibarger, student member of the board. Presence of the members of the board demonstrates their commitment to education and the pride they have in our students and their many accomplishments. At this time, I would ask that all Greeneville City School educators stand to be recognized. Each of you have had an impact on the lives of our graduates, and we thank you for your dedication to their success. The past 6 months have been challenging, to say the least. Seniors, I know you may feel like the coronavirus has stolen your senior year, but one thing it cannot and will not steal is your future. This pandemic does not diminish your accomplishments or the potential for greatness we see in each of you. I am proud of your dedication and resolve, and I admire your ability to face adversity and keep moving forward. While it may not be the senior year ending that many had dreamed of, it is your senior year, uniquely celebrated and one for the history books. I implore you not to look back or dwell on what could have been, but to focus on creating what will be. Be thankful for the many blessings you have received, memories you have made, and the many opportunities that lie ahead. In the words of author John Gordon, let your trust be greater than your doubt, your faith be greater than your fear, and your purpose be greater than your challenges. Continue to look for ways to love, serve, and care for others. Look forward. The vision for Greeneville City Schools is that our graduates will be prepared and confident to own their future. GHS class of 2020, your teachers, administrators, coaches, extracurricular sponsors, and other school staff members have done everything within their power to provide you with a world-class education. And you have honored them by the level of your success. As you embark upon your chosen path, I believe when others learn where you attended high school, you will be pleased and proud to hear their comments regarding your alma mater. Be confident in and believe in this preparation and use it to achieve your dreams and fulfill your destiny. Arthur John Maxwell states, the only true freedom each of us has in life is the freedom to choose. The most important choice is who we will become. We cannot wait to learn of who you will become and the achievements you will accomplish. Mr. Fraley, I am pleased to accept this graduating class. On behalf of the town of Greeneville, the Board of Education, the administrators, teachers, and staff of all Greeneville City Schools, and by the power vested in me by the state of Tennessee, I hereby declare you graduates of the Greeneville City School System. Congratulations and Godspeed.
Carter William Adams. Thomas Mark Adams. William Clint Albright. Ryan Julian Alter. Serena Neve Anderson. Kaylee Mason Armstrong. Natalie Renee Babb. Trajan Deontay Baker. Javier Lee Balbuena. Richard Micah Banks. Alexandra Cheyenne Barner. Jordan Elijah Arnett Batson. Carter Christopher Beach. Emma Elizabeth Bedingfield. Elijah Patrick Burney. Samuel Wilson Bowman. Cameron Lee Bradley. Yep. Sorry. Robert Durrell Bradley III. Haley Elizabeth Bratcher. Braxton Alexander Bryce. Abigail Lee Brown. Elijah Parker Brown. Jordan McKenna Burgess. Parker Seaver Burns. Grant Allen Bustler. Margaret Catherine Butler. Sadiq Numar Cameron. Shaheem Malik Gerald Carnes.
Hold on.
Joshua Edward Carpenter. Flint Donald Carter. Violetta Catalan Diaz. Okay. Keziah Marie Wallace Chambers. Tommy Dale Chandler Jr. Quentin Dion Chapman.
Proud of you, my man. Congratulations.
Jeremy Isaac Clark.
Jeremy, congratulations. Proud of you.
Callie Rose Cobble. Alex Haley Jade Collins. Chase Richard Collins. Cooper Thomas Collins. Sarah Marie Coutant. Bellanira Cruz Enriquez. Kara Elizabeth Cutshaw. Braden Chandler Cutshaw. Ethan Marion Dabbs. Bailey Lee Davis. Maxwell Tyler Dean. Isabel, come on. Isabel Joy Delbridge. Alyssa Lynn DeRocker. Cameron Matthew Devotai. Madison Michelle Dingus. Nathan Andrew Dockery. Madison Ann Dudley.
Elizabeth Fern Ellington. Tyler Lee Ellison. Lexi Nicole Etherton. Robert Norman Fairchild.
Robbie, congratulations.
Blaine Connor Ferguson. Zuriel Figueroa Ramirez.
Good job, Zuriel.
Ada Corinne Fillers. Victoria Elizabeth Bowman Fillers. Sydney Claire Fincham. Carolyn Ann Fitzgerald. Charlie Kate Flagler.
Congratulations, sweetie. Very proud of you.
Caitlin Lauren Fletcher.
Congratulations. Proud of you, sweetie.
Wade Patton Ford.
Good job, buddy.
Congratulations, my friend. Proud of you.
Madison Grace Foster. Ainsley Michelle Freeman.
Go ahead. Christopher J. Everhart.
Megan Mariah Rose Gas. Got it. Kyla Brianne Gillespie. Macy Nicole Goods. Joseph Michael Gosnell.
We will.
Audrey Helena Gal. Emily Elizabeth Graham. Ashton Ryan Grinier.
Oh, yeah. I love you.
Adrian Jerome Greenway. Marley Alexis Gregory.
Congratulations, Marley.
Dawn Yvonne Griffin. Sarah Grace Grubb. Chelsea Lynn Gunter. Presley Brooke Gunter. Gunner Nicholas Isaac Hajopoulos. Marissa Jasara Hankins. Austin William Harris.
Congratulations, friend. Yes, sir.
Ashlyn Riley Harrison. Keontae Daquan Harrison. Stephen Michael Hay. Isaac Gray Haney.
Congratulations, buddy. Proud of you.
Ty Augustine Hendrickson.
Congratulations, my friend.
Cameron Lynn Hensley.
Congratulations, Cam. Appreciate you, buddy.
Yasmin Anofre Huertas. Brianne Madison Grace Hurd. Seth Michael Husky. Adam Michael Heibarger.
Congratulations. Very proud of you.
Ethan Chad Inscore. Charles Eben Jones III. Roland Edward Jones.
Congratulations, sir.
Billy Eugene Keith. John Bladen William Keller. Macy Alexandra Kennedy. Michaela Lorraine Kendall. Angel Trinity Klepper.
Kennedy Brianne Knight. Aubrey Elizabeth Knopp. Raymond James Knuckles. Desiree Lachey LaFollette. Alyssa Dorothy LaSalle. Seth Aaron Lee. Markayla Leanne Light. Carrie Cheyenne Livingston. Austin James Levin. Mackenzie Lane Lowry. Jaden Walter Manuel. Jaden Walter Manuel. Manuel, sorry. Levi David Marks. Isaac Wade Marshall. Christian Michael Martin. Cassie Rianne Martin. Sarah Madison McCullough. Andrew Joseph McGill. Sophia Marie McInturf. Benjamin Riley McNeese. Caleb Michael McQueen. Allie Faith Medlin. William Robert Medlin IV. Leah Nicole Melton. Devin Andre Millar. Ian Samuel Miller. Lily Danielle Million. Leighton Elias Mitchell. Reed Hawkins Mitchell. Michael Marcade Moore. Noah David Moore.
Noah, congratulations, sir. Yes, sir.
Isaiah Jaquan Morong. Hunter Nathaniel Bryce Murchinson. Keelan Marshall Newton. Caleb Ryan Norris. Garrett Lee Norton. Jack Thomas Ottinger. Okay. Krista Noel Owen.
David Lee Painter.
Chelsea Marie Paul. Briseida Perez. Elizabeth Ann Phillips.
Clarissa Bell Price. Jaden Lloyd Pruitt. Miriam Lisbeth Ramirez. Kylie Grace Reeves. Rosalind Yates Reed. Abigail Ann Renner.
Congratulations. Great job.
Joseph Andrew Renner. Alexia Marie Reyes. Grace Elizabeth Riley.
Congratulations, sweetie. Proud of you.
Sydney Akia Rourke. Rebecca Bontica Rosen.
Congratulations, baby. Very proud of you. Thank you.
Tamron Faith Rowe. Ruby Ruiz. Ivy Madison Runyon. Victor Sanchez.
Congratulations, my friend.
Christopher Lee Sayers. Jaden Xavier Scruggs. Anlushan Amaki Sintel.
Congratulations, Shaw.
Emily Grace Shaw.
Quit talking, come on. Congratulations, sweetie.
Alex Kane Shelton.
Yes, sir. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Yes, sir.
Amber Brooke Shelton. Colby Bryson Shelton. Jaden Christine Shelton. Austin Lee Shepherd. Lila May Shockey. Kaylin Marie Siegert. Bridget Leela Smolkowski. Braden Joseph Spano. Caleb Lance Sparks. Garrett Ryan Spradlin. Lacey Marie Starnes. Aaron Jerome Stewart.
Congratulations, sir. Yes, sir.
Alexis Eva Taylor. Jace Andrew Noden Teal.
Congratulations, my friend.
Caitlin Marie Thomas. Hallie Abigail Tweed. Austin Dale Vance. Jacob Edward Velez.
Elizabeth Danielle Venerable. Sulaimi Christina Vincente Tax. Sophia Noel Wakefield. Chloe Suzanne Waldrop. Matthew Frederick Wallen. Sierra Nicole Wampler. Kaylee Diane Weber. Bailey Gabriella Weems. Siobhan Marie Weems. Abby Elizabeth Whitaker. Matthew Brian White. Kenley Kate Wilhoit. Mason Daniel Williford. Anna Lee Wilson. Gavin McKenzie Wright. Tyler Shane Yarber. Madison Lynn Yokley. Arthur Vester Youngblood IV. Eric Lee Zook.
Again, we thank you for your patience, understanding that we didn't get to have practice, and this is the first time we've done it this way. I think it was done many years ago this way at Greeneville High School, but this is the first time we've done it in a long time. So, again, I want to thank, as Ty did, the folks who made this happen, the guys who got these chairs set up and the stages and the sound and all that. Thank you very much. Okay, everybody's back in their seat. Seniors, if you will, please rise. You began this ceremony this morning as members of the Greeneville High School graduating class of 2020. With the awarding of your diplomas, you may now transfer your tassels in honor of your status as becoming members of the GHS alumni class of 2020. Congratulations. If everyone would please rise, join us in the singing of the Greeneville High School alma mater.